يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. اللهم اجعلنا من الفائزين واجعلنا من التوابين واجعلنا من المتطهرين واجعلنا من ورثة جنة النعيم واجعلنا عندك من الصائمين من القائمين من المقبولين. آمين آمين. We praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى and we thank him for this great opportunity to pray Jumu'ah in the month of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah that he made us to live and witness today a Friday in the month of Ramadan. Double reward and a great opportunity for us to have our sins forgiven and our du'as granted and answered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this month of mercy, in this month شهر الرحمة وشهر الصبر وشهر الشكر, and this month of gratitude and this month of patience. Alhamdulillah, we've been witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and we've been witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and messenger. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam and Iman, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah that we're praying our first Jumu'ah of this month of Ramadan. And we are, Alhamdulillah, already fasting for the last few days and experiencing this great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The world does not understand how we make it for 17 hours. It's not really difficult. Alhamdulillah, Allah gives you barakah of suhoor and gives you the barakah for the good intention. And you fast this month of Ramadan, seeking his blessings. Fasting is a great act of worship. It's an act that is needed today, not only for Ramadan. Fasting is a concept. More than an act of worship, it's a concept. Fasting is about abstaining from things we're allowed to do, so we can raise the standards and it'll be easy to leave the things we're not supposed to do. We raise the standard of the believer so he can say no to things that he's allowed to do, such as eating and drinking and the other things in life. So when it comes to things we're not supposed to do, it'll be very easy. This is the idea of fasting. And this is the concept of taqwa. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. This concept of taqwa is extremely important. We may say it, but we have to understand what taqwa means. Taqwa was explained by our scholars in our tradition that if there is a fire, you avoid it. How do you avoid fire? You avoid the fire by wearing the, you know, fireproof uniform. So the firefighters, they don't go and fight the fire just like that. They put something called taqwa. So the fireproof uniform, that protection that they have is called taqwa. Taqwa means you're conscious of the danger. You're walking in the street and there is a mud and you raise your clothes so they don't get, you know, dirty or stained. That is taqwa. This is the concept of Ramadan and fasting and taqwa, is that we are raising our standards so we don't do things that we may be allowed to do. In a way, it leads us to avoid things we're not allowed to do. That's the concept of صوم is to abstain. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. The concept is the same, but the method is different. As you read in the Old Testament and the New Testament, that the fasting of Jesus was continuous for 40 days. He didn't drink or eat. And the fasting of Maryam and Zakaria was by abstaining from talking. إِنِّي نَظَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَ الْيَوْمَ إِنْسِيًّا. They stopped from فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ. So to use the sign language, and also Sayyidina Zakaria, in order to have a son, he begged Allah when he was inspired by Maryam and he wanted a child. قال يا مريم وأنى لك هذا قالت هو من عند الله إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. He saw the fruits, he saw these good things that Maryam عليها السلام she had. He said, how come you have these things? She said, it is from Allah. هنالك دعا زكريا ربه. At that moment, she inspired him. He was a prophet. And Maryam, she was in a maqam very high. She inspired him to turn to the mihrab and ask Allah ta'ala to give him a child. He wanted a child. He was like in the situation of Ibrahim alayhi salam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him that, he said, you should fast for 3 days. Why? So you can get closer to Allah. You will avoid maybe things that will spoil your dua. And this is why the month of Ramadan, a person who fasts, his salat is multiplied. In some hadiths, it's 70 times. فَمَنْ تَقَرَّبَ فِيهِ بِخَصْلَةٍ مِنْ خِصَالِ الْخَيْرِ كَانَتْ كَسَبْعِينَ فِي مَا سِوَاهِ وَمَنْ تَقَرَّبَ فِيهِ بِفَرِيضَةٍ فِي رَمَضَانِ كَانَتْ كَسَبْعِينَ فَرِيضَةٍ فِي مَا سِوَاهِ أو كَمَا قَالَ صلى الله عليه وسلم. Whoever does something good in the month of Ramadan, it'll be 70, and some scholars said 700. Times better than outside Ramadan. And if you do one fard, something that you're supposed to do, it will be 70 times better. It shows you the importance of the month. But the whole thing about Ramadan is about the Quran. Shahru Ramadan, the month, the importance and the sanctity and the holiness of this month of Ramadan stems from the holiness of the Quran. For the Arabs, Ramadan was not a holy month. It is Rajab, it is Dhul Qa'dah, Dhul Hijjah, and Muharram. These 4 months are the holy months. But Ramadan's holiness is different. It stems from the holiness of the Quran. This makes us reflect in the first Jumu'ah of the month of Ramadan. What is this fasting, this Hajjud, Taraweeh, all of these restrictions? It's all about the Quran. And that's why he said, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. شهر رمضان. So Ramadan has no importance without the Quran. Ramadan is a season to commemorate the revelation. And Allah made it in 30 days. So it's a season where we can dedicate not only our bodies, but our mind and our soul to concentrate on the concept of revelation. This is extremely important that we understand and we make the next generations understand that this Ramadan, had it not been for the Quran, it would be nothing. Ramadan was like any other month before Islam. And I mean here Islam, the advent of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When the Quran was revealed, this is where we need to focus. This Quran is a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all humanity until the end of times. And it should be put this way. It's a message from the Khaliq, the Creator, to the creation until the end of times. And Allah knows when is the end of times. So if the Quran is so important, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the point, He wants us to read it in Salat and to implement it. And one of the ways to implement it is by fasting. So the fasting person is a person who raises his standards to become Quranic. We all know the hadith, كان خلقه القرآن. عائشة رضي الله عنها described the Prophet in very brief words when he was asked, when she was asked, what was the character of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم? She said, كان خلقه القرآن. His manners, his character, his personality was the Quran. So the Quran would be the blueprint. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم would be the model home. When you go now by, you go to developers, they have land and they have one beautiful house. Usually it's the best house with all kinds of upgrades. You never get the same house like the one you saw in the model home. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the model is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So you want to see the implementation of the Quran? Look at this person, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hence we understand the sunnah. The sunnah is the implementation of the Quran. And that's why we follow Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. We follow our four imams who explain for us the Quran and the Sunnah. So the Sunnah is the way to practice the Quran. I'll give you an example. Before I came in here, I'm coming to Jama'ah, I can see people fighting over the parking. That is, the parking is not mentioned in the Quran. Correct? But parking is mentioned implicitly in the Sunnah. Sunnah is adab. Sunnah is take permission. Sunnah is to listen to ulil amr, as the Quran says, to listen to the people in charge. I am maybe a boss in my factory. I have 500 people working for me. I might be the professor at the university and I have thousands of students. But when I come to the parking of the masjid, the boss is the security guy who is there in charge. That's ulil amr. Now we follow the sunnah and the Quran. Unfortunately, we live in a way that is totally separated from the teachings of the Quran. Sunnah is the way. Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he drove a car and came in here, he would abide with the laws, qanun, regulations of the place. If he lives in Canada, he would abide with the laws of Canada and he would never break them. If he is in a multi-faith setting, he would respect other religions and he would never speak ill of other religions or any other gods. وَلَا تَسُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَسُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. Quran says, do not talk ill of other gods that they worship, even they are false gods. Why? Because that will make them also, they will create a reaction. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took the Quran and made it applicable. So if I don't have the sunnah, I cannot understand the Quran. If I don't understand the sunnah, these people say, you know what? You don't need the sunnah, you don't need hadith. You can explain the Quran by yourself. The Quran doesn't tell us how to pray, doesn't tell us how to fast with details. What are the things that nullify fasting? Doesn't tell us how to fix our salat. Doesn't tell us how to do the details of Hajj. Yes, the Quran speaks in general and on principles. So you need the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the month of Ramadan, we live the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The sunnah is when somebody is yelling at you, indulging you in fight and quarreling, what do you say? Sorry, my standards are higher. I can't go down. فَإِنْ سَابَّهُ أَحَدٌ أَوْ خَاصَمَهُ أَحَدٌ أَوْ شَاتَمَهُ أَحَدٌ فَلْيَقُلْ إِنِّي صَائِمٌ. If a person tries to indulge you in fighting, in screaming, I don't want to see Muslim brothers coming to Jumu'ah and fighting over the parking. That is not Islam. That is not Islam. The poor security, I said, brother, how is it? He said, may Allah be with us. Let's be patient. Wallahi, mashallah, make dua for them. And we come, because we're bosses and we're big in wherever we are, we boss other people. That is not Islam. مَن تَوَاضَعَ لِلَّهِ رَفَعَهُ. You may pray, fast, maybe you do anything, but if you're not مُتَوَاضِعَ وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. And the real servants of Allah, عِبَاد is the plural of عَابِد. عِبَاد, the worshippers of the Most Merciful. Abid is plural of abd. Ibad is those who worship Allah truly by fasting and doing tahajjud and qiyam. It is shame that to our masajid you go and people not respecting each other, not lining up, not properly doing things. It is, then what was the benefit of Ramadan? What's the benefit of fasting? We need to live Islam, my brothers and sisters. We need to live Islam. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam predicted this. And this is the reason why we have too much knowledge today, but we don't have the implementation. And Rasul sallallahu says, Inna Allah, la yaqbid, inna Allah yaqbidu al-ilma, إن الله لا يقبض العلم ينتزعه انتزاعا ولكن يقبضه بقبض العلماء حتى إذا لم يجد الناس علماء اتخذوا رؤوسا جهالا فاستفتوهم فأفتأهم فضلوا وأضلوا. This is our time. Allah will take away knowledge not from the books or from Google, from the internet. He said he will take it away not by snatching it, like literally snatching it, but the people who really understand will go. And what will come? People who talk a lot, ru'usan juhala, they talk a lot without knowledge, a practical knowledge. يُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. You need the kitab, al-Quran, you need the wisdom how to implement, and you need tazkiyah. Without this three, you cannot move forward. And this was why Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam succeeded. He focused on the book, the wisdom how to implement the book, and tazkiyah. We need tazkiyah. And Ramadan is the month of tazkiyah, month of purification. So that's why he said they will take people who don't know, and what will they will do? They will mislead themselves and mislead others. And today everybody knows. You talk to someone, brother, can I tell you? He says, no, I already know. I did my research. Khalas. This is the problem we have. يَقْتُرُ فِيكُمُ الْجَهْلِ. النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, there will be too much ignorance. Subhanallah. Today we have all kinds of knowledge. You can't talk to nobody these days. Everybody knows. Everybody's alim. كُلُّنَا طَلَبَةُ عِلْمُ. All of us are seekers of knowledge. لَا مَا زَالَ الْعَالِمُ عَالِمًا مَا دَامَ فِي طَلَبِ الْعِلْمِ. A person is a scholar, is a person who knows, so long as he seeks knowledge, so long as he's willing to learn. And we have to learn. And the dilemma we have and the problem we have, we are not learning. We have reached, I know. The moment you say, I know, you don't know. And that's what Shaytan la'natullah alayhi did. He said, I know. You don't tell me what to do. And this is the reason why Ramadan is about taking this Quran and see what is my relationship. Am I fasting a folkloric Ramadan? A cultural Ramadan? Or am I fasting a spiritual Ramadan? And this is why the Prophet ﷺ spoke about akhlaq. فَأَرُوا اللَّهَ فِيهِ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ خَيْرًا. Show Allah the best of yourselves in the month of Ramadan. The world knows. The world knows that this it's Ramadan. They should see the best of us in the month of Ramadan. فَأَرُوا اللَّهَ مِنْ فِيهِ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ خَيْرًا. Show Allah the best of yourselves as a father to your children, as children to your parents, as a mother to your children, as children to your mother. Show the best of yourself as an employer to your employees. Show yourself the best of yourself as employee to your employer. Show your best of yourself as a neighbor to your neighbor. Show the best of yourself as a citizen to the nation. This is why Ramadan is so important. It's a season like no other season. And we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for blessing the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with this month. Not only we focus on man sama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaba ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. Yes, whoever fasts. And another hadith, man qama ramadana imanan wa ihtisaba, whoever prays or whoever fasts Ramadan with strong iman, with faith, an expectation of Allah's reward, an expectation of Allah's promise, all his sins will be forgiven. It's good. It's good to have that. But that's at the personal level. And how about the other level, which is even higher? That's the level of Islam. How about the level of Ihsan? Huh? Where we are called al-muhsinun. Ihsan and Islam, you all know this. But in Ramadan, we should think of Ihsan more. If we are going to show Allah and everyone the best of ourselves, we need Ihsan. What is Ihsan? To do more than what you're asked to do. And this is why you're encouraged. You don't have to pray Taraweeh. It's perfectly fine. You don't have to. Nobody said it's fard. You see, people are keen for Taraweeh, but they are not focused on the fard. وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدٌ بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَدْتُ عَلَيْهِ. You can never come close to Allah, he says, except with that which I have made obligatory on you. Then he said, وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهِ. And my servant keeps coming close to me with things I did not ask him to do. Nawafil. Nawafil means purgatory things, extra things. And when he or she does that, I love him or her more. We need to focus on first, what am I required to do? Then I can do things I am not required to do. If is praying Isha more important than Taraweeh? Yes. Praying Isha fard on time is better than praying Taraweeh. Doing something that Allah wants me to do is more important than things I am encouraged to do. And in Ramadan, we train ourselves to do things that we are supposed to do, and we add. And when we add, this takes us to the level of Ihsan. فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُهُ كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ وَبَصَرَهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِهِ وَيَدَهُ الَّتِي يَبْطُشُ بِهَا وَرِجْلَهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِي بِهَا وَلَئِنِ اسْتَعَاذَنِي لَأُعِيذَنَّهُ وَلَئِنِ اسْتَغْفَرَنِي لَأَغْفِرَنَّ لَهُ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. And once I love him or her, I become the hearing with which he hears, the sight with which he sees, the hand with which he touches and strikes, and the leg or the foot with which he walks. Meaning, we become a person who lives by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us take this month of Ramadan where we're supposed to raise our standards and smile. Isn't smile as charity? The more you smile in Ramadan, the better for you. Why? Subhanallah, they say smiling actually triggers the right hormones to act, and it's good for the heart. All of the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, you'll find all the gems. But the Quran by itself cannot, you can't understand it. Most of, even Arabs, they read the Quran, they can give you tafsir. It's not that it's not meant to be understood. It's put in a very proper way, and you need the context. And there are stories that don't seem to relate to our time, but you need to see the connection and the parallels and the wisdom, and you use analogy. فَاعْتَبِرُوا يَا أُولِي الْأَبْصَارِ. To use qiyas and take the incidents. There are hadiths that might sound like irrelevant, and Allah mentions some of the incidents, and He talks about camels and goats and things. But you take the lesson. Huh? The Arabs, for instance, we use a hadith. This hadith, you know what? It's old. Who has goats now? They used to, not milk the goats or the cows for many days and then take it to the market, okay, to sell it. So you give the impression that this is a good milky cow, milky goat. It gives a lot of milk. So they didn't milk it for a few days. And then, of course, so people say, wow, I'll pay good price. This has a lot of milk. But then they realize that it's a trick. So you can take that very old example about goats and apply it in modern things. When you give wrong impression to the customer, when you hide and patch the defects, you don't have to have the actual goat. You just take the lesson. Rasul ﷺ, with his means of 1400 years ago, he gave a lesson. I take a lesson and apply it in a modern way. I buy a computer from you, but this computer, when it heats up, it breaks down. It's the same thing, different story, different problem, but it's about giving wrong impression. When you do business, you don't give. So we need these things, and we need scholars who can take the sunnah and explain it in a modern way. And today in Ramadan, we focus on the Quran and focus on how to apply it by understanding the Sunnah, but we also need al-hikmah. And wisdom, wisdom is very important, because wisdom will help us apply the Quran and make it relevant to our children, to the world, so they can see it. But as a text, it won't be relevant for them. It will be relevant in our actions, in our akhlaq, in the way we present it. So it becomes, as we always say, صَالِحٌ لِكُلِّ زَمَانٍ وَمَكَانٍ. It's good for all the time and all the places. Briefly, this is the month of Ramadan. We need to know the four rites of the Quran. Number one, all of us should do the best to learn how to read it. Number two, to understand it. Number three, to apply it. And number four, to teach it to the world. Every Muslim should go over these four stages. Learn how to read the Quran. وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. Number two, apply the Quran as much as you can. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ. And number three, teach it. خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. Understand it, and then apply it, and then teach it. نفعني الله وياكم بالقرآن الكريم وبشهر رمضان العظيم وجعلنا وياكم من عتقاء النار. آمين. استغفر الله الغفور الرحيم.